Understanding energy transport in stars is as simple as lighting a candle. We have a candle. Candle is a source of energy, in this case combustion of wax and oxygen. Energy is being generated continuously. It's being transported continuously as well. The first way is obvious. You can see the candle. Photons from the candle flame are coming up to you. How are the photons made? Well, the base of the flame, it's blue. Those are the hot gases that are actually coming off of the melting paraffin and combusting with oxygen. The yellow is all the soot particles that are being made in that combustion, lighting up as little black bodies. And you see them as a soft, continuous glow. That's what makes candles such nice light sources. A pure gas flame would just be blue, like on a gas stove. Photons are very effective at transporting energy because they are, at base, little packets of energy that move at the speed of light. This room is completely transparent and clear, so you have no problem getting the photons from the candle flame into your eyes, into a camera, anywhere you want those photons to go. They fill out the room. If the room was filled with fog, you wouldn't see the candle as easily, but eventually you would notice there was a glow inside the fog as the photons rattle and scatter their way out around the water droplets in the cloud. Photons are very, very effective at moving energy from one place to another. There's a second way that energy is being transported away from the candle flame, but you can't see it easily, but you can feel it. Air is being heated at the very top of the candle flame. It becomes buoyant and rises against gravity, carrying the heated air from the top of the flame away. That's a form of energy transport called convection. You can feel it. If you carefully place your hand over the candle flame, you feel the warm air convecting off. The other way we can see it is not to look with our eyes, but look with an infrared thermal camera, and we can see the hot air plume continuously convecting upwards from the flame. A third way that the energy can be carried away is also less obvious to the eye, but more obvious if we look in different ways. The energy is being carried away by atoms in the solid material of the candle, moving one next to the other, slowly transmitting the heat away from the candle flame through the body of the candle. That's in part how the candle wax melts and the candle keeps going. This is called conduction. We can see this more easily if I take a wire containing copper, which is a highly conductive metal, and I place it right down in the candle flame. Now you might not think we're going to see very much here, but if I were to touch the end of this rod, after a short while I will feel it beginning to heat up and eventually get so hot I have to bring my hand away from it. Energy is being transported from the flame atom to atom, hand to hand, like a group of people pushing each other in a football stadium, eventually the energy reaching the ends of the wire. Again, not easy to see and easy to feel, but if we shift our view to an infrared thermal camera, we can actually watch this process of conduction because we can see the thermal emission from the increasingly hot copper. Now we have the infrared thermal camera view. You can see it's hotter where the wire is in the candle flame, but as you watch the wire, especially towards the left-hand side of the frame, you'll see the wire getting brighter and brighter in the infrared, and as we wait just a little while longer, you'll notice that it's now getting a uniform hot temperature all the way along its length.